Maps allow you to organize your cameras and other devices graphically. To create a new map from an existing graphic file, select Maps from the configuration tree on the left-hand side. Click the New button at the bottom and then give the map a name. Click Map Image to open the file window and browse to the location of the map file you want to import. Map images may be bitmaps, JPEGs, PNGs, or static GIFs. It's recommended that you use a compressed graphic file such as a PNG or JPEG to improve responsiveness. Select the file and click Open to display the map. You also have the option to add a custom icon for each map using the Add Icon button. The systems you are currently connected to are listed in the Available Items panel. Expand the system to see the devices associated with it. Drag the name of the device from the Available Items panel onto the part of the map where the icon should be located. Right-clicking on the icon provides several display options. To flip the icon to point in another direction, right-click the icon and select Mirror Icon. To rotate the icon, select Icon Rotation and select any of the available options. To change the appearance of the icon, right-click, select Icon Balloon, and then select one of the available options. If the device is a camera, an additional option exists to draw a cone representing the camera's field of view. Right-click on the icon and select Show Field of View. A small cone appears, which the user can select and drag out to indicate the camera's field of vision. Right-clicking again will allow the user to change the color of this region or remove it from being displayed on the map. You may also choose to show the names of each icon. This is very useful in identifying devices on maps with multiple devices. To remove an item from a map, right-click it and select Remove Selected Item. To complete the setup of your map, click Apply. Note, if a map has not been given a name or no devices have been placed on it, you will be unable to use the Apply button until completed. To delete a map, simply click the map in the map tree and click Delete. To view a map, return to Live Mode and open the map from the Live Maps list on the left. Double-clicking on an icon will display the video or data from the chosen device. If your ExactVision servers have enterprise licenses, you can use the Nested Mapping feature. Nested Mapping allows you to drop down from map to map. In this example, we will start with a map of the world and drill down to our corporate office. In our example, we're going to create four layers in our nested map. As previously mentioned, you cannot save a map if there are no devices on it. So to perform this, we'll create all of our nested maps down to the lowest layer and drag our devices onto the lowest layer map and save it. Then we will link each of the child maps to the parent. In this example, we've prepared map images, but you can use any set of images in order to follow along. In this configuration, we'll create a world map that drills down to a country map, then a state map, then maps of our office and warehouse. On these lowest layer maps is where we'll place our devices. We begin by creating a map we'll name World and add our map image. Then, without dragging any devices onto it, and while it's still highlighted in our map tree, we click New again. This time we name the map US and add a map of the US to it. Clicking New once more, we create a map for the state of Indiana. Finally, we create our lowest level map for our office. We now drag the devices onto the map where desired and click Apply to save our changes. We want to add an additional map at the state level, so we highlight that parent map and click New. Bring in our map image and drag devices onto it and click Apply. With our nest of maps created, we need to link the tree of maps together so users can navigate through them. We highlight the parent map, in this case, the world map. from the available items list, we'll drag the US map onto it and click Apply. When finishing a process, always select Apply to save the changes. Next, we highlight the US map and from the available items list, drag the Indiana map onto it. Now we place the office and warehouse maps onto the Indiana map. After successfully creating your maps, test them from the live screen. Here, I've added additional maps for Europe and Japan to extend this example. Your nested maps don't have to represent a global scale. They can be arranged to fit your needs, such as a school district or university with several buildings, or several floors of the same building. To drill into a nested map, double-click on the icon created. To zoom out of the map, simply double-click the icon in the upper right-hand corner.